Hello everyone. So I'm going to show you an interesting problem today, and how can you use solver to solve this problem. And at the end, I'm going to show you how can you overcome the solver limitation. Okay, so basically the problem is that you have an industry or factory where you produce this the two size of product. So one is 75 inch and the another one is 55 inch, and you have a water to deliver, and the requirement is like this. So he needs 36 inch long and quantity will be 40, 25 inch long, quantity is 150, 13 inch long and quantity is 350. So you need to find a way to fulfill this criteria, and at the same time you need to reduce the waste. So what is the waste? So for example, if I slice this 75 inch by this combination, okay, so I slice this 75 by let's just put this one for, okay, so if I slice 75 inch in this combination, so it's 236 inch and the rest of the number is zero, so our waste will be 3 inch, right? So 36 multiplied by 2, it's 72, and as the main or original product was 75 inch long and I am using 72 inch, so 3 inch is waste in this case. We cannot use this one to deliver to any customer, okay, as the minimum requirement is 13 inch, and this is the waste. Okay, so you need to minimize this waste, and you need to slice this 75 inch and 55 inch to fulfill these requirements. So this is the problem. So you need to prepare a combination table, okay, so I can use two slice and the rest are zero, and I can use one slice of 36 inch, one slice of 25 inch, one slice of 13 inch, and then waste is one, and I can use one slice of 36 inch, three slice of 13 inch, and in that combination the waste is zero. So as you can see, the if we choose only one, then it's not fulfill our criteria, right? So I need to change this variable, so I can choose I can use five product for this combination, or 7 or 10, I don't know, I need to find that. Okay, so this is our combination table, and this is our decision variable. I will talk about later. So let's find the waste in this case. Okay, so the waste is that if we multiply this with this number, right, so it's 2 multiplied by 36 inch, 0 multiplied by 25, 13 multiplied by 13, so it's 72, and then the waste is 75 minus this number, right, and I need to multiply by this one too. If we use one, then it's 3. If we use five product for this combination, then it will be 5 multiplied by 3, so it will be 15 inch waste, right? So that's why the formula is that 75 minus multiply this one with this one and sum up this, that's why I'm using sum product, and at the end this is our per quantity waste. Now I need to multiply with the using quantity, so this one, right, so this is our waste, and as this is for 55 inch, so I need to replace the 75 by 55, that's it. So this is our waste calculation, and at the end I need to find the total waste, so this is our total waste. I just sum up this number. Okay, and this is that total required number. Okay, so if we choose this combination, then I get 236 inch. If we choose this combination, then I get 136 inch, right? So this column multiply by this column is the total number of 36 inch log, right, or 36 inch product, and again I need to multiply this number by this, so I am using sum product function. I need to multiply this and this, or in this case, or in this case, I need to multiply this one, multiply this one. So that's why I am using sum product. So now let's move on to the solver section. So the condition or criteria is that I need to minimize this waste. So this is our objective function that I need to minimize it, and I can change this number, right? I cannot change this section because it's all the possible combination. Okay, so I can change this number. So this is our decision variable. I can change this and I can compute the waste. Okay, and our constraint is this, that this cannot be negative, right? And at the same time, it cannot be fractional. I cannot use 2.5 product. Okay, so it's need to be integer. So it's called integer linear programming problem. And this number need to be exactly this one equal to this one, and this one equals to this one, right? Okay, so now we need to add this to solver. So let me just reset all. Okay, so our objective function is this one, and I need to minimize it. That's why I'm using minimize, and I can change this decision variable. And our constraint is this, that this number need to be greater than or equal 0. At the same time, this number need to be integer. Right? So this integer. And I need to use this one. This number must need to be equals to our order value. So this one. Okay. So these three are our constraint, right? And this, as this is the simplex linear programming problem, now all the things are given, right? So we this pattern, then it say that is get an output, right? So click okay, and now we can see that this is our final output, and final waste would be 180 inch, and I need to use 89 product, 89 quantity of product of 75 inches and 59 of 55 inches. And I don't need this zero combination because I am not going to use that one, so I can filter this. Okay, just filter it by zero, include zero and this one. So I need to use this combination 111, and I need to use one log for this 10339 number of product in this combination, 49 in this combination, and this is for 55 inch, as you can see. Okay, sorry, 49 in this case, and this is for 75 and 55. This is the 55 inches cases. Okay, and this is our final output. Okay, so this is our solver approach. Okay, and you need to manually produce this combination table. Okay, and you need to use solver, and at the same time there is some limitation in solver, as it's a free edit, you cannot use more than 200 decision variable. Okay, so here I have only 11 decision variable this section, F12 to F22, but you cannot use more than 200 decision variable, and it's very hard to produce 200 combination for this problem. If we have on more product criteria, or if we have on more type of more type of production size, or this number is changed, then this table will be larger. So it's hard to manually do these things. So that's how I am preparing code for this problem, so that I don't need to produce this combination table or anything, or I can overcome the solver limitation. So this is the initial creation. So number of unique type of stocks, in this case we have two. So if we select two, there will be two text box and number of unique type of required things. This is 3, and there will be 3 text box for this. So I need to just add this number 75 and 55, and it's 36, 25, and 13. And then there has some button. It's not finally done yet. So I have solved or save solution. You can save this in Excel format, or you can save this in a docs format, or you can save this in a PDF format. So for your report section, okay. And in this save solution, there will be no zero combination. So as we don't need this zero combination, we only need the one combination section or greater than zero combination section, right? And you can see all cut pattern. Now it says 11 cut pattern, 0 0 1 1 1. This one. If you click this button, then you can see all the cut pattern. And for example, if I add 15, so it's showing up a message that instead of that many text box, click data from Excel button. So you need to click this button and add data by that. So when you have more than let's say 14 table, so I can use 14. So if I use more than 15 type of stocks, then it's better to get the data from the Excel, right? Or you can use this button when you have only 2 or 3 type of data. It's not a problem, and it's easy to work with the large data set. So you don't need to manually type all this data, right? So you have 5, 5, so you don't need to type it here or there, okay? So this is the interface. It's not finished yet. Thank you everyone. If you have any question or query or suggestion, please let me know. Bye bye.